Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to continue the last part of the lesson development. That is BMI and HDI. BMI means body mass index and HDI means human development index. Both are very important topics in the study of development. BMI is used for the calculation of nutritional standard of the people. So in order to understand the development, as we consider health status of the people, nutritional standard of the people is very important. So in order to understand nutritional standard of the people, calculation of BMI is helpful. And how can we find out BMI? BMI, body mass index, is which means which can be calculated by taking weight of a person in kilogram divided by height square in meter. So weight in kilogram divided by height square in meter, we can get BMI. And next, that is HDI, human development index. That is or human development index is another important concept. It human development report, which published by UNDP, compare the countries based on educational level of people, their health status, and per capita income. So human development report, as we have studied about, the World Bank also studies the development. So their report is different, that is based on the per capita income. But human development report or HDI is an index, and UNDP, United Nations Development Program, it compare the countries based on educational level of people, health status, and per capita income. Per capita income is also used in order to calculate the development. So human development index is very broad concept, while World Bank this average income method or per capita income method prescribed by World Bank is a narrow concept. Next, let us study about next another topic, that is in the textbook given, sustainability of development. As we have studied in geography, sustainability of development is also another important concept to study about the development, because resources are used by people or countries enormously. So this resource use, overuse, can lead to the exhausting the natural resources. So sustainability of development is a part which studies, which make the awareness regarding how to control overuse and how to make use of the resources properly and judiciously. Development which happens without depleting natural resources and harming environment. Sustainability means development which happens without depleting natural resources and harming environment. Groundwater table is decreasing due to overuse. We can see many of the places groundwater table is decreasing. Why the groundwater table is decreasing? Because there are many reasons. First is agricultural production. For agricultural production, another thing, for settlement, people use to get water, they use groundwater, means many ways to get groundwater. So agricultural overproduction or agriculturally prosperous regions where we could see groundwater overuse. For example, if we observe Punjab and Western UP, groundwater is or more consumption of groundwater we can observe. So if this use of groundwater without any sustainable development, one day this groundwater can be exhausted. Even though groundwater is a renewable resource, if we overuse it without considering the future needs, it can be exhausted. And we can see that renewable resources and non-renewable resources, we could see that renewable resources, groundwater, I have told you, that is replenished by the nature. and it is a renewable resource. So resources and non-renewable resources, we can see some differences between it. Renewable resources which are replenished by the nature. Non-renewable resources we have limited in amount and cannot be replenished. So non-renewable resources cannot be replenished and renewable resources can be replenished by, it is replenished by the nature. Renewable resources example, we can say groundwater, sunlight example, etc. Non-renewable resources means petrol, coal, etc. So if we consider the development without depleting natural resources, we can say that sustainability of development, which is very essential for the development of a country. So development of a country is not only determined by the income, it is a very broad concept. It takes into consideration different concepts. I have told you that health status, per capita income, net attendance ratio, then educational level of the people, and other than that, a country's sustainability of development is another important concept. And as we know that sustainability of development or environmental degradation is due to the indiscriminate use of resources. So if we curtail the consumption of the resources, there can be sustainability of development, and it can save our environment. Environmental degradation is not limited to particular region, state, or any particular locality. It is a global concept. It affects, environmental degradation affects every parts of the country, or it affects all globe. So it is, the consequences of environmental degradation is not limited to any particular region or state or a place. It affects all globe. That is why it's our foremost duty to save our Mother Earth. And for that, sustainability of development is very essential. So we have studied today. In this lesson, we have come across various concepts. First, we had studied about development and developmental goals. Then we have studied developmental goals are different to different people. Again, we have studied that developmental goals are conflicting. Then we have studied that per capita income is one of the important concepts to measure development. But the World Bank, which studies per capita income, which takes into consideration per capita income as one of the important factors for development. And then we have studied about other criteria for development. That is, I have told you that the BMI, then HDI, these all are very important for the study of development. So, this development is a very broad concept, and it does not limited to some particular factors. It is very broad concept.